We are using the software Microsoft Encoder for Microsoft Expression Encoder for screen capture software we are using to record screen recording. By using this software, I am recording. Here, I want to explain how to use dish norms. Suppose so many places people publish dish norms, low, medium, high, or deficient, low, medium, high, and toxic. Like the three groups or five groups, they express and they give dish norms. But how best we can utilize these dish norms? I wrote a program to utilize these norms. Suppose I collected dish norms from tobacco dish norms from methods of soil analysis, HLS Taunton book. I collected dish norms, tobacco, in the chapter plant analysis by Bargo and Raghupati. Bargo and Raghupati, they wrote one chapter in HLS Taunton, Methods of Soil Analysis. In that book, he mentioned dish norms in tobacco. These are the dish norms. These are the optimum values, sufficient range, or optimum, sufficient, or medium, low, medium, high. This is medium or sufficient range. Insufficient, low and high. 3.5 to 4.5, this is the range. Suppose nitrogen, 3.5 to 4.5. Phosphorus, 0.2. Like this, 12 nutrients they have given. Then what I did, I got the mean values. And next to how I got this mean values, you see, E4 plus F4, this and this I added, and average 0.5 means off. I halved the values. So I got mean values of these two things, two rows. I got mean value. And generally, according to dish norms, 4/3 ST, they give the range. Mean plus 4/3 SD, this value. This will mean minus 4/3 SD. This criteria generally people use. So based on that, we got 4/3 SD. Means high value of the sufficient range minus 3.2875. We got SD standard, 4/3 SD. Mean plus 4/3 SD is equal to 4.25. So we got this 4/3 SD. And we got in this row SD. By multiplying with 3 by 4, we got SD. And this is a coefficient of variation. Coefficient is of variation is nothing but SD by mean into 100. Standard deviation by mean into 100 means for 100 units mean, we got SD of this, means this coefficient of variation. Coefficient of variation is nothing but standard deviation by mean into 100. We got coefficient of variation for all these things. Generally, in dish norms, people select the values from high-yielding variation, high-yielding population. So these are the coefficient variation from high-yielding population we got. Now, how to utilize these norms? For unknown sample, for testing unknown sample or testing any sample. Suppose we got this is tobacco crop. We got a sample from farmer's field. This is nitrogen 3.7, phosphorus 0.35, potassium 3, calcium 2.1, magnesium 0.5, sulfur 0.5, iron 120 ppm, manganese 145, zinc 45, copper 35. We got these values. This is the test sample. We feed this value here, 3.7. Suppose 3.25. Again, I am feeding This is equal to 0.225. This is 2.24. This is 2.1. This is 0.6. 0.4 sulfur, iron 110, manganese 140, zinc 40, and copper 30. Like this, we got values. Now we get the data. Here, we get, in this line, we get the indices. Here I prepared a program so that we got indices, DRIS indices. Here for nitrogen, we got minus 11 and phosphorus 22.2 to potassium minus 9. Like that we got. Suppose here iron, you got minus 49.4. Here, whichever more minus value, that is more needed. Here in this sample, this iron is more needed element. Okay. This is taken first step. We have to give iron. Iron, it is deficient in iron. So, this sample should be taken care with by supplying iron. Next, zinc. Zinc micronutrients. Next, manganese. Means more native indices means more native index means more needed element. First, we have to take this criteria. First, we have to supply iron to this plant. Next, zinc. Like this, we got order of importance for this sample. Means already we diagnosed. And we can get imbalance index also. First, we remove the negative sign. How to remove the negative sign? You see, I have given formula. B4 to the power of means scaled power of 2 and bracket to the power of means first I scaled and again square root it. Now we removed this minus value, all this. So we got, we added, this is imbalance index. The more the imbalance index, the low yield we expect. Means for getting more yields, this imbalance index should be less. Okay. Next, in this step, we got mean values from this this norms. We got mean values. We extracted mean values. This mean values only we interpreted here. Nitrogen, phosphorus. These above values only we are expressing here. Mean values from the table means from high yielding value. Here I wrote a program here in. These are the ratios from standard values. We got mean values. In the same way, we calculate all the ratios. Nitrogen by phosphorus, nitrogen by potash, nitrogen by sulfur, phosphorus, like this. All ratios we calculated. And for the test sample also, we interpreted the same test sample. Values above we fed, those values again we interpreted here. For this test sample also we calculated the ratios and coefficient of variation we got here 47. In 47 row we got for coefficient of variation from the table we extracted. Next, function. This is standard values, means, high, low. Then function we wrote according to DRIS norms in Walworth and Sumner, advanced in soil science. We got this function, how we have to calculate this function between low yielding between high yielding population and the test sample, how to wrote. Right, this is interpreted, and like that we prepared for all the nutrients. We wrote the fractions also. We wrote the functions. Next, we prepared index. this index here. This this index come to